Okay, so the securing screws, we screwed in with the simple PZ2 screwdriver, and for the rest of the installation I will use a special electrician's PZ2 screwdriver for to install the grid side of the inverter, which I'll show you next. So here we remove the cap from the grid inlet. The whole cap, and then we have to make a hole through this rubber band here. Then I already have my cable pre-made, so this is 5x6mm cables. It's fit for most residential size inverters. Okay, so first I put the cap on, because then I won't be able to. If you for the purpose of this video, we pre-made this cable, but if you are working with a non-pre-made cable, it is logical to only blank the cable once you installed it inside the inverter. So now you can see me struggle. But you drive it through the hole somehow. Okay, and now you can drive it through the grid inlet. All the way up until it sticks, and then you screw the cap on. You screw it tight so it's airtight, watertight. It's IP65 if you do it right. Okay, now we continue with the connection of the cables on the grid. Which side? It is recommended to first connect the B and then the zero. So this is because, of course, the inverter was tested before shipping, but you do not know what could happen to it while the transportation. So for this reason, we use a flathead bit again. Also recommended to do it by hand or on the lowest setting. First I attach the B cable. Always check your connections, then zero. Nil. Okay, and we are done with the flathead. Now we use this guy. The phase order is very important. I always use brown, black and gray. Of course, you can use any other order, but this is the official. Okay. Let me check this. It's in the right place. Now it's in the right place. So screw it down tight. of course, the circuit breaker at the other end of this cable is totally switched off. And also I measured the voltage on the cable before connecting it. Okay, so the grid side is now connected. Phase order is also important because later if you install the current transformers, and it should, they should have the same phase order as here, because as your measurement will be off. Okay, so now we connect the PV. I have prepared one string for you here, and this should be connected to the appropriate poles, the bottom of the inverter. And I always go from left to right and use the first inlets first, so you know which string is which. This is why also the cable is marked